اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك لبيك
لبيك لبيك.
نحمد ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. أما بعد, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. To all our wonderful viewers of ITV, MashaAllah, we're still in the spirits and we're still in the Vumma of Hajj itself. May Allah Ta'ala, we all have a longing. May Allah Ta'ala grant us that longing for Hajj to Baytullah, inshaAllah. Amen. My dear friends in Islam, Hajj is one of the pillars of Islam. In fact, it's the last pillar of Islam. And Rasul Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam has said, the one that Allah has given, afforded the means to go for Hajj, should undertake this beautiful journey. A journey of a lifetime, my dear friends, a journey of hearts. And we find that Hajj itself, it's all about movement. And like the classical English says, in movement there's improvement, in haraka there's baraka. For example, in front of me I got a cup of tea, but there's no sugar in there. Oh, there is sugar in there, like they say. Although I'm not a person much for sugar, let's say there's honey inside there. But you did not stir it, you say there's no sweetness, you just got to stir it a bit. When you start to move in Makkah, subhanAllah, there's no ibadah that's got so much of movement than that of Hajj itself. Sometimes you hear always, we're going to do the walking Hajj. Mawlana, do the walking Hajj. Hajj is walking from the time you made the intention. You've got to go and walk. You've got to go walk to get your passport. You've got to go walk to take the photos for your passport. You've got to walk here for stamp. You've got to walk there for that. You've got to walk this way, that way. And then you've got to walk to the airport. Then you've got to walk from the airport to this to get your luggage. And then you've got to walk to the hotel. And from Medina, just picture you walking every time to and fro to the Haram. And for every step that you are taken, good is written to your account. And a sin is erased from your account, subhanAllah. And now suddenly you come, you don your ihram in Medina, and there you come with your ihram and the talbiyah of labbaik, Allahumma labbaik, and you come to Makkatul Mukarrama. And in the hotel there, that you have your ihram on, and you can't wait now to walk towards the haram. And as you're walking towards the haram, your matov, the one that's guiding your people, will say after him, Allahumma, O Allah, inna hadha al-haram, that this haram, haramuk, this sacred place is your sacred place, O Allah. Wal baladu baladuk, and this city of Makkatul Mukarrama is your city, O Allah. Wal amnu amnuk, and the safety and the security of this place, it belongs to you, O Allah. You are the giver of safety and secureness, Ya Allah. Jituka min biladin ba'ida. I've come from Cape Town, I've come from Gauteng, I've come from Natal, KwaZulu Natal, bidhunubin kathira, with bags, loads of past sin, Ya Allah, a lot of baggage of the past, O Allah, wa'amalu sayyi'ah, and so much of huna, so much of sin, Ya Allah, so much of bad that I've done, Ya Allah, if you have to weigh my good and my bad, the bad would outweigh the good, Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim, as'aluka mas'al al-muttarin, Ya Allah, begging, I'm like a beggar coming to you, I'm a pecharo, I need your mercy, I need your forgiveness, I need your pardon, Ya Arhamar Rahimin. The weight on my shoulders, I come with Table Mountain on my shoulders, but I'm crying to you like a ghulam, crying to you and begging you to forgive me, Ya Allah. And I'm asking you, Allah, I'm afraid of your punishment, your wrath, and I want to leave back home with you haven't forgiven me, afu. You have pardoned me completely, granted me a clean slate. When making that dua, and now you've come right near the Kaaba, and when your matov, your guide is telling you, you can lift up your eyes and look at the Kaaba, your first looking is mustajabul dua. And as you are looking at the Kaaba, the tears flows, your emotions goes high, and you are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah Ta'ala's Prophet has said, Udu'u Allah wa antum muqinun. Whilst in the state of dua, believe firmly, my Allah is accepting this dua. Because it is said that the first sight of Baytullah, as a guest of Allah, as ambassador of your own family and country, you are مستجاب الدعوة. وليف فأو أنربو الشيخ حفظه الله شيخ سليم بيك that is also undertaking this journey to give us some tastes of the tawaf itself.
سبحان الله بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. مولانا والله you just really really took me back now to my last umrah سبحان الله last year Ramadan that I was able to go and perform the umrah. You just took me to that entire journey process from Medina, coming into Makkah, and going into the Haram with our mutawif, you know, making the dua with the people there, teaching us, you know, what should be said and how it should be done and so forth and so on. And then once we came as close as we could to the Kaaba, everyone stood and we gazed at the Kaaba and everyone was making dua. And then we started with the tawaf, subhanallah. Just as Molna says, the idea of the movement, it's a very, very prominent factor in all the ibadah that we are now making in Makkah and Medina, alhamdulillah. The idea of walking around the Kaaba and alhamdulillah being blessed to have memorized the Quran, alhamdulillah, I really, really enjoyed much more than being able to recite at any other point in my life. But I so much enjoyed doing my recitation of the Quran in the tawaf that I did, my 7 rounds of tawaf, subhanallah. In that regard, I perhaps personally preferred a little bit more to be on the outskirts or to be inside the building or to be, even be upstairs on the roof. Why? Because the walk is quite a bit longer, so I would be able to get a little bit more recitation of my Quran in when doing those rounds of tawaf. Nonetheless, alhamdulillah, we were able to walk. The mutawif that would walk with us would constantly remind of different adhkar that the people would make, and many of the people would join with the mutawif, and other people would go about reading their own dua, making their own dua in Arabic, in English, in whatever language they knew, they would make those duas. But the one thing, and of course we know this is established in the Sunnah, the area between the Rukn Yamani and the Hajar al-Aswad is where Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam made an all-encompassing, very, very beautiful dua, where he would say, رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. This word, حَسَنَة, O Allah, grant us goodness in the worldly life, and grant us goodness in the year after, and save us from the punishment of Jahannam. Very beautiful in that it would encompass goodness in every single facet of our worldly life. Every avenue that we would go down, our businesses, our families, our work, our children, etc., etc., all of these different avenues, Ya Allah, grant us the best therein. And of the Akhirah, grant us the best therein and save us from the fire of Jahannam. So we see here that this dua is actually divided into 3 parts. One part asking for the positives of the dunya, and the other 2 parts asking for the positives of the Akhirah and also protection from the negatives of the Akhirah, subhanallah. So how important is then our efforts, and how should we divide our efforts in our lives related to this dua that is made in the tawaf? My effort for my dunya should definitely be there, of course, because this is where I live. I need to live in a house, and I need to drive a car, and I need, and I need, and I need, and I need all of these things that I need, because that is how Allah Ta'ala had created us. And I must strive to achieve those things, undoubtedly. But Allah Ta'ala tells us in the Quran, وَابْتَغِ فِي مَا آتَاكَ اللَّهُ الدَّارُ الْآخِرَةِ. Use what Allah had given you to search for the year after. Use skills and abilities and resources that you have to find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through that. And then our efforts for the year after should then of course be double. We should make effort to seek the positives of the Akhirah by doing the fard, by doing the sunnah of our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then we should also seek protection from the negatives. So we should try to stay away from haram. We should try to stay away from makruh as best as we possibly can. And whatever shortcomings there are, Allah in his ultimate mercy allows us to always make up for them with the tool of tawbah. So we ask Allah Ta'ala to bring this dua, to make this dua a reality in our lives, where we are conscious of our dunya that we need, but doubly so we are conscious of the akhirah that we are all traveling towards. This is one of the greatest things that for me, Mullah, that stood out in the tawaf, and the significance of this dua in the tawaf that we make.
Allahu Akbar. In fact, as Mawlana so beautifully rounded off to say that Inna Rabbi la sami'u du'a. If we look at Ibrahim alayhi salam, for homework, my dear viewers, just go dot 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 Ibrahim. or go to Surah Ibrahim, and you'll see du'as of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. That Allah has left there, and then he's mentioned in the Rabbi la sami'u du'a. Yes, my Allah has answered all my du'as. He has accepted my du'as. We know he longed also for a son. And his wife, Sarah alayhi salatu wasalam, she could not bear him a son. Eventually, she allowed him to, we have to cough this side because of the lockdown. But not only because of the lockdown, also I remember my ustad Mawlana Qasim Sima rahmatullah alayhi used to teach us the sunnah method whenever coughing also, you know, you take a handkerchief up and show us like a, when you're sneezing, sneeze into that. And today they're coming to teach us of this lockdown and the viruses, etc. But Allah give us understanding, inshallah.
Amen.
But nonetheless, where was I now, Sister Mawlana?
The dua of Nabi Ibrahim.
The dua of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam, where he said, Inna Rabbi la sami'u dua. Allah Ta'ala accepts my dua. So we must also believe, as Allah's guest, whatever dua you are making there, you can even just recite the Quran, be in dhikrullah, of make a lot of du'as. Don't forget to make dua, a beautiful dua also from the Quran. Rabbana ighfir li, he said, Allah forgive me. Rabbi ja'alni muqima salati wa min dhurriyati. This Ibrahim alayhi salam left for us in the Quran. That Allah allow me to establish salah. What is to make salah, but what is to establish salah with all the nitty-gritties that Rasulullah has laid out for us. Subhanallah. Wa min dhurriyati, and my offspring. Rabbana taqabbal du'a. Rabbana ighfir li, oh Allah, forgive me. Wali walidayya, forgive my parents. Walil mu'minina, and all the believers. On the day when we are accountable to stand in front of you. I end off, my dear friends in Islam, where Rasulullah said, إِنَّمَا جُعِلَ تَوَابِ الْبَيْتِ وَالسَّعِي بَيْنَ الصَّفَى وَالْمَرْوَى وَالرَّمْيُ الْجِمَارِ لِإِقَامَةِ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. The whole essence of the entire package of Hajj, the tawaf, the sa'i, as well as pelting of the jamarat, it is only to take the beautiful name of Allah. Ayyul Hujjaj Afdal, when Rasulullah was asked, which is the most outstanding Hajji? Rasulullah replied, أَكْثَرُهُمْ لِلَّهِ ذِكْرًا. The one that is mindful Allahness constantly. May Allah Ta'ala make us of that, inshallah. وَمَا تَوْفِيكِ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ وَبَرَكَاتُهُ.
لبيك لبيك لبيك.